Hello sir, welcome to the BIG Conclave Adventure Center. Could you summarize for our audience the impact of BIG on the biotech innovation system?
I think BIG, by its name, Biotechnology in Ignition Grant, has really been able to ignite the passion of innovation in the very difficult sector of biotechnology, which is inherently poised with the long gestation period, higher risk appetite. You need a lot of infrastructure to be made available for testing the innovative ideas. So today we are sitting in 13th call of BIG,
yeah.
And ever since it has really increased the quality of proposals, as well as made us, given us that flexibility to choose the best of the proposals. So the competition is high, very high in fact. And as BIRAC, as a facilitator or an enabler, we've been able to create that required ecosystem, infusing mentorship, support from expertise, IP, legal, bring in investments into this ecosystem other than grants in it, equity systems, angels, investments, and then enabling the outreach so that they can be made more competitive outside India as well.
Yes.
Not only as frugal, affordable innovation for the masses as such, which relate to the Indian settings, but I think much, much larger than the Indian setting itself.
Okay,
so
it's
been doing well. It also brings us the challenge, how we'd want to retain and sustain it, and the efforts which have been put by the young innovators,
yes.
Can we facilitate a higher rate of translation?
Yes.
So I think that is the next challenge leading us to.
Okay.
To facilitate their journey towards successful entrepreneurship.
Okay.
So I think that is the working area that we have to
focus on
right
now. Okay. And what do you think are some of the challenges which some of these BIG grantees, you know, after they complete their project, in their scaling up and just going ahead, like you're saying, you know, becoming sustainable businesses and scalable businesses, what are some of the challenges specifically that BIRAC would like to address?
See, in my mind, there are essentially two bottlenecks. One is the understanding to scale. The idea is good, technically very sound, whether it has the commercial viability or not. If we are working on an idea, we need to work not for today.
Yeah.
We need to see 5-10 years down the line when the idea matures into a product.
Yeah.
Who are my competitors?
Yes.
Is there a business viability at that time? Would there be any takers 5 years, 6 years down the line? So that is the roadmap an innovator has to be clear once they are stepping into this journey. Second, I think the innovator is mostly technologist who is very sound in the theoretical technology, but they lack the business aspects of it. So the business co-founders are grossly missing in most of our young innovators and startups. So these are two major aspects. As from BIRAC's perspective, there was a third aspect, which is the regulatory hurdle. We are trying to facilitate that. So BRBC Regulatory Center is one such example to do that. I think challenges are more. We need to keep on facilitating, but I think these two, three are the major ones really need to focus on.
Then in your opinion, what are maybe like a mature incubator like Venture Center, what sort of promise and potential do you see for an incubator like that to kind of, you know, help mitigate some of these challenges or play a bigger role?
These are assets. These are Venture Center Pune like incubator. These are assets and great contributor in creating and facilitating such innovation ecosystem. I think as a value addition to the entire ecosystem, we need to scale. Venture center, for instance, needs to scale. They create many more venture centers like them. And in the process, like they can handhold the tier 2, tier 3 regional, tap the regional innovation capacity and the local talent. In the process, when venture center replicates like 10 other venture centers, this parent venture center becomes one huge mature cluster and can really, really create a major difference.
So from a BIRAC perspective, I mean, are there any plans to maybe facilitate, like you're saying, you know, like mature incubators like Venture Center, ITP, CCAM, for them to grow and build a larger network? Is there any support in place to maybe help them do that? Or is there anything in the pipeline which can maybe, like, because we all agree that, you know, like today even Dr. Renu Swarup was saying that we need to go into tier 2 and tier 3 cities. So is there any way in which, you know, BIRAC is planning to help the incubators actually scale up and do that?
Yeah, as a mandate, we are now sitting at, we have created 31 incubators, yes, pan-India basis. BIRAC, big partner, one of them is our venture center Pune. In next couple of years, by 2020, we intend to increase this number of 31 to 50.
Okay.
So there are potential incubator creation capacity which is sitting, and if venture center dwells into it, creates and supports more, so there is already a provision.
Okay. Right? Finally, this is your first conclave. How's your experience been so far?
I have been connected with the innovation, and so as you rightly said, this is my first experience here. I'm thoroughly impressed by the quality of speakers have been put together and the energy in the participants. The exhibition was populated with good representation. And I think it is infectious in nature. So everybody, the peer-to-peer learning, that is what I'm looking at. And alumni transferring the knowledge, committing for hand-holding.
Yes.
These young innovators, when they mature, if they become ambassadors of innovation in biotechnology, I think that is the message I would leave with them. And whatever we can support from the functioning BIRAC body, we will be very happy to do so.
Thank you so much for your time. Have a great day.